I am a doctor, I am eye specialist, but I have deep relation. I want to create a deep relation, very deep relation to Almighty God. So I want to talk about for a few minutes, your precious time. About 10,000 years ago, this earth was here. According to research, this earth was here, plants were here, these buffalo, monkeys, cows, they were here. But there were no human being. 10,000 years ago, there was no human being on the earth. That's the research. When first human being came from Almighty God, his name was Adam, he came to this earth with his wife, his name was Eve. So, 10,000 years this life started from here. Now, 10,000 years, it looks too much for us because we only live like 60 years, 70 years, Mr. Mandela 95 years, and Mugabe baby cross 95 years from Zimbabwe. Yeah. But ultimately, everybody has to die. This is years. 10,000 years, first person came to the earth. But all the creation was here. Even the snakes, small insects, everything was here. I'm telling you, they were enjoying their life. I think very deeply sometimes. This earth really belongs to these animals, not a human being. We came as a guest in this earth. These, all the animals, all the fish in the sea, all the birds were flying, they were there. They were enjoying. Now we came 10,000 years, we started growing our cities and our towns and stuff like that. We push them away. We eat animals. We have to survive. This is how it works. But anyhow, why a human being was created by Almighty God? When there was angels for millions and billion years ago, the sky was there, this earth was there, everything, all the planets were there. So why Almighty created this earth for human being? Why the human being was created? So Almighty God, his name are different. One of the Maulana comes, he says Kulutul. We, the Muslims, say Allah. But it's the same name of same one God. Same one God. He created a human being with a different category and meeting with different power. This power is power of wisdom, which is in our brain. Elephant has a brain, monkey has a brain, even small mouse, they have a brain, but their brain are so tiny. They think about eating, they think about sleeping, and they think about making children, and they die. They don't think more than that. Because the brain, the capability is very short, very small. Human being, the brain is the biggest brain as compared to the body on the earth. Because all the wisdom is here. A human being was sent to earth with this capability that he can recognize what is wrong and what is right. Even the animals, sometimes they know what is wrong, what is right. Because the dog is sitting there, he's hungry. And you are having a lunch, he don't jump on you and he take food and run away. No. He's still disciplined a little bit, that he know that I mustn't go there. When my time will come, I will get the food. Who planned the water come from the seas? Come into the clouds and then put rain, beautiful, clean water for us to drink. Who is managing that? Who is managing the whole universe? Who is managing this sun and moon and stars and earth and water system? Who is there? There is someone who is managing this thing. Who is eternal power, is management power. He is Almighty God, only one God. If we deny, you can deny. There is no hospital, there is no sun, no moon, I don't believe it. You can't believe it. But your heart, your mind says, oh, there is one God. There is some power who is instructing us to do something. So there is a God. So He created us. And He will wake us up one day. This day comes when we will wake up. We will be standing in front of Almighty God like I am standing in front of you. And He will ask us, I gave you health, I gave you life, I gave you wisdom, I gave you food, and I gave you a system to run in the community. What you have done with that one? Will there be any answer that time if you don't prepare for that? You will be very astonished. How come? One time, we have a small center. A group of thieves came to steal something. Is it bad? Four or five thieves come. They stole something, some computer from the center. So we were going around.
But nothing happened. 2 months ago, later they came again. Now there was a room, have windows on the back. But the door, which was opening into the yard, it was out of order. So one of the thief, they sent him to the window, they broke something, said, jump in. The small tiny thing, he jumped in the room. When the room is dark, now nobody can stop me to steal the thing. So he went out and start opening the door. From inside door, you know that we can open the door from inside. It was out of order, lock, stuck. Then he said, what must I do? He started pushing. And he cannot go back. There is a small window. You can jump in, but you can't go out. By the time he was doing this noise, the brothers who were staying here, his brother Munadar, and he was staying there, but they heard what is happening here. They realized there was a thief inside. He was like a mouse into a cage. They called the police. And here we are. He was arrested. Did he plan to be arrested that time, that night? No! He planned that he will go. He jumped in. He will enjoy. But he found him in there. And such a small room and he was arrested. People who don't believe in Almighty God, they will find him into a small dark room one day when Almighty say, here we are. You are in front of me. How you are denying my presence? And how you are denying that I am not going to see Almighty God? I am here. Tell me how you spend your life. Hey, women will say, but God, I couldn't see you. How can I believe you? He said, you know, I know you, you answer like that. I sent special people to you all the time. Holy prophets were sent to you among yourselves. And all the time, you heard Prophet Adam, Holy Prophet Noah, Shuaib, Elias, Prophet Abraham, Isaac, Ishmael, Jesus Christ, Moses, Harun. These were the holy prophets. Jibrail, the Gabriel one, he used to bring message from me to him to tell people that believe in Almighty God. Use the wisdom to worship Almighty God, and good must do good in the community. Those, you have heard about that, sir? Ah, yes, yes. Oh my God, I heard about this one. I said, Jesus is the holy prophet. I said, Moses was the holy prophet. But I didn't trust them. I didn't believe them. Why? Because I want to worship my own desires. I thought I have to eat like an animal, I have to sleep like an animal, I have to make children like an animal, I will die and make myself a dust under the grave. I thought so. He will be told that Those holy prophets who are telling you A to Z, and other people who are companion, the people who believe these holy prophets, they are also telling you, trust, you are going to be one day standing in front of Almighty God and tell accountability of your life. So he said, oh, is it possible for me to go back to the earth, do the good, and come back successful to you? He will be told, time has gone. You will never be given a chance to go back to the earth. Oh my God, tell me the person who is successful that day or he is not successful a day is not equal. They are not equal. And you heard, Almighty is giving heaven to the people who will be obeying them, who will be obeying the holy prophets, who will be behave in this earth, he will behave in the community, they will be given heaven. The people who don't behave, people who are cruel to other people, people who are committing atrocity, killing people, their place will not be gender, their place will not be heaven. They will be punished and they will be going hell. My dear brothers and sisters, does it make sense or not? It makes sense. You have given your independent wisdom to believe what you want to believe. But inside your heart, Almighty knocks you. He knocks you. That says, I am here, your creator. Sometimes you recognize, yes, someone is looking after me. And you didn't listen to me. Now, you didn't behave. You didn't lead your life according to the teaching of holy prophets. You were asked to go for a prayer to remember Almighty God. You said, no, I'm going to sleep, I'm going to eat, and doing wrong things. Now time for judgment. If a person goes to heaven with palaces, with all the good things there, and if a person goes to the hell, go to the fire, they are not the same, my dear brother and sister. And as we think, tomorrow is coming, tomorrow will be Tuesday, we all believe it. Same way, we should believe the day of judgment is coming. Everybody will be standing, Mr. Drogwana, Mr. John, everybody, Mr. Toomey, everyone will be standing with me in front of Almighty God. And we will be recognizing each other, Mr. Idris, and you, Mr. Afri Barfani, you are there, and doctors, nurses, the politicians, all will be standing in front, seeing the big King Almighty sitting there and deciding about our life. It is not the same. It is not the same. If we have to go there, you know, if there is death penalty, everybody who sends kill somebody, he knew that I could be hanged. So he knows. So now if we know that a day is coming when I will be caught, so I will be sent into the heaven or into the hell, our behavior will be totally different. Totally different. So what is a hell? The famous boxer Muhammad Ali, you must have heard his name, Muhammad Ali Khan. He died a few years ago. He was Muhammad Ali the Great. So he was boxing, in the boxing world, he was the champion and champions of champion. He was a very powerful person. One time somebody was interviewing him. I saw this interview on the YouTube. Somebody asked him, Muhammad Ali, your power is very, very much, you are a strong person. Wealth, you have lots of wealth. You can do anything you like. You rape as many ladies you want. You want to eat anything. You want to do whatever you do. But why you don't do these things? Who stops you doing these things? Muhammad Ali said,
that I will be standing in front of Almighty God one day. And He is going to decide whether I am going to hell or heaven. Whenever I think about the heaven, I think about that good life. When I think about the hell, I just want to imagine what is hell like. The fire of hell is 70 times more sweet than the fire of this world. He said, what I do, I keep matchbox in my pocket. Matchbox, even matchbox in my fire. He showed that this is matchbox. I always keep. So when I want to feel, to do something wrong, I switch on one my match and put my finger on it. Where is it? I take it back. Then I ask the question, Muhammad Ali, this is a very mild fire. You cannot bear this pain. By doing this wrong thing, how you can bear that fire with 70 times more after the death? When I think this one, I go back, thank God, I am not going to commit this crime. My dear brother and sister, this is a great pleasure to have eyes, ears, health, wealth, whatever, but these are blessings from Almighty God. We have to make thanks to Almighty God. Almighty God, Almighty Allah, who is one? That thank God you gave me this one. What must I do? He says us, you cannot live like an animal here. Not like a lion, tiger, a wolf, who will interested into eating, interested into sleeping, and interested into sex. No! You have more than that to do. You have to adopt a system which I gave you, system how to live around yourselves. Don't lie. Pray to Almighty God. Don't gravity, don't believe to you. I want justice in your society. You have to do this one because you are a human being. So my dear brother and sister, we enjoy our life, but we must think what system must run in this world. One example, I need 1,000 rand. I go to friend, I want 1,000 rand because I want the ABC. He say, I will give 1,000 rand, but after 6 months when you return this 1,000 rand, you must return 1,500 rand. Is it unusual for you to hear that? No. You go to the bank, ask them, I want a million rand for buying a house. Oh, good morning, sir. Please have a seat into a call room. Okay, you want 1 million rand? Yeah. Oh, so how am I going to pay? Oh, you will pay 10,000 per month. And so many years, okay. He goes, oh, we calculate 10,000 multiplied by 12 multiplied so many years. He said, oh my God, this is 2 million rand I'm going to return back. 2 million rand, you took 1 million, use it, and when you return this 2 million rand, you are sweating, burning your hard daylight work, or money is going to bank. That is called interest. Almighty God says, interest is fully prohibited, nobody is allowed to take interest. But we don't like. We don't like because system is not running without that. Almighty say, His Holy Prophet say, nobody is allowed to take interest. If you are giving 1,000 rand, you should be having a big heart to give. When taking back, take 1,000 rand. What you will get in response, Almighty God will be happy with you. He is building a house for you in the heaven. If you believe Almighty God, we will do that one. If people believe in that one, they will even come over the weekend and help the people. But if they don't believe, they will do. This is one of the examples. Almighty say, no interest. And we know people. One time, very, very nice person came to me. See, doctor, I took some overdraft from a bank. I want to renovate my house. I did it. And I expected some money to come some way, couldn't come.
Now I'm paying every month what I could. The money is staying the same. I pay 8,000 and each month, 100,000 money is still the same because interest comes. I will finish my life, interest is still there.
Almighty doesn't like this one, my dear brother and sister. Change the system where human live like human. Change the system, marry a lady. No girlfriend, no boyfriend. You cannot have a sex with a person without marriage, out of marriage. Your sex today, you will stand in front of Almighty God. He may punish you. So why we spoil our life? Why we do these things? Why we eating or eating of money? If I have a knife, can I don't have a knife, a right to kill other people, to stab other people, I grab, take money. The Creator is seeing you, seeing the crime, He will catch everybody. Although some people are caught here as well. Accountability is here as well, to a degree. But full accountability will be on that day. My dear brother and sister, after maybe a month, I will be 60. So my time to retire me is event is there. So I want to open my heart in front of you that we are doing this towards grave. Let us think very carefully. A person going to hell and going to heaven cannot take place without toss of a coin. Oh, Mr. John, you look very smart. Heaven, what? You don't look so hell. Almighty will never decide like that. He will decide 100% on the act what we do in this earth. And some people, I don't wrongly, they say, oh, if I say a few words, I like this one, I have this belief, that belief is enough for me to go to heaven. Just a small belief will take you to the heaven. Just a small belief will take you to hell. It is not justified. It is not justice. Whole life should be accounted for. Then you will be seen whether you have destroyed your life by the sins, by the wrongdoing, by falling devil, then somebody will go to hell and other people will go to heaven. So it is not easy task. Me and you are sitting into an examination hall. We are writing what must we write, what must we do. And we believe it that there are two angels sitting right and left. Army sent to write each and everything, and the book is getting ready, and we will be given that book when we die. This is what we have earned from the earth. Then we have to get answer. So this is what I wanted to talk to you today. This is towards the end of the year, and a good work is done. You are in good mood, and I said, let me narrate few things which I learned from my life. Which I learned from the life of Holy Prophet Jesus Christ, which I learned from the life of Holy Prophet Muhammad, Prophet Abraham, and his signs in the earth. So I hope I didn't bore you too much. It was just a journey which I wanted to take you while you are here, where we are heading. And thank you very, very much.